We've seen that we can take potential flow elements and add them together. And because each of the individual elements satisfies Laplace's equation, the summation of those elements also will satisfy Laplace's equation. So what we're going to do here is add three different elements together to create what's called a Rankine oval or a Rankine cylinder. So this is created by adding a free stream velocity to two sources. So I'm just going to draw here our x and y axes, and we're going to put one source to the left on this x-axis, and this will be a positive source, so this will have flow emanating out. And then on the right side, I'm going to put a negative source, so it's also known as a sink, of the same magnitude. Okay, so we have a positive source on the left, a negative source on the right. And now let's look at what happens as we move away from the left source and our velocity emanates out from that left source. Remember, it drops off as 1 over r here on the left-hand side. The velocity in the radial direction out from that source drops off as 1 over r. And so there's going to be some point where that velocity is equal and opposite to the free stream velocity. Now, there's also some influence from the source on the right-hand side that's actually a sink. And I'm kind of neglecting that, but it doesn't change the fact that there will be some point here on the left-hand side where the velocity is zero. And again, that creates a stagnation point like we've seen before. So now let's draw a few streamlines here. We've got a stagnation point on the left, and let's look at streamlines really close to these sources and sinks. So what's gonna happen is, for example, if flow emanates out from the right here, from that source, it will go directly into that sink there. If it comes out at an angle, it will get pulled in there, and we see that actually all of the flow from this from the left source will get swallowed up by the sink on the right. So that creates some flow field that looks like that. And then we have the stagnation point out to the left, and that will actually be part of a streamline that creates a cylinder around this flow structure inside. And so none of the free stream velocity coming in here that's below or above that will actually enter this region. So we'll have this region enclosed in green here that is called the Rankine oval, and no mass will cross that region. And on the right-hand side, actually, we'll also have another stagnation point, and we could prove that mathematically again, but it's the same thing as the left-hand side. There will be some point where the flow coming into that source is equivalent to the, or equal and opposite to the free stream velocity, once you include actually the effects of both sources on that point. But anyway, that will create another stagnation point over there. So this, so now we see that we have a source and a sink internal to some geometry here that creates an oval, and the flow field external to that oval is continuous and differentiable. And so let's just label our stagnation points here really quick. So these two are our stagnation points. And we actually have no singularities in the flow field of interest. So most likely what we're interested in is the flow external to this geometry. And you can imagine that by moving the actual location and the strength of these two sources, of the source and the sink, that we could create different shapes of ovals and different types of geometries that and we could then the flow field external to that geometry is a potential flow and actually is the solution to the inviscid flow that would flow over a geometry of that shape. And we have no singularities in that flow field of interest, which is external to this geometry. Internal, the flow field doesn't really matter to us. What we've done is created a flow field in there using these singularities that produce a boundary or some streamline here that that flow will not cross, and it connects these two stagnation points. And so flow won't cross this boundary here. And so the flow external to that will represent the flow, the inviscid potential flow over a geometry that is shaped like that. So that flow field external to that geometry is continuous and differentiable and satisfies Laplace's equation at every point in the flow.